I recently learned that Q-Day is coming, and it might be here as soon as 2025. What's Q-Day? A new conspiracy theory? Something with quokkas? But no, Q-Day is the day when quantum computers will be able to crack the current encryption protocols that we use on the internet. But there'll also be quokkas in this video. Let's have a look. Quantum computers are devices that exploit entanglement between their computational units, the quantum bits, or qubits for short. Entanglement is a type of correlation that only exists in the quantum realm. This entanglement correlation can be moved around, and that can be done in many more ways than are possible on a conventional computer. This is why quantum computers can do certain calculations much faster. One of those calculations that quantum computers can speed up is factoring large numbers into primes. Trouble is that the long time it takes to factor large numbers into primes is the base of the currently most common internet encryption algorithm called RSA, after its inventors Rivers, Charmier and Edelman. This and similar encryption schemes all rely on mathematical problems that are easy to create but difficult to solve. It's very easy to multiply two large prime numbers, but very difficult to find out the factors given their product. You can use the product as a key to encrypt your data, but if you want to decrypt the data, you need to know the prime factors. You can try getting them by just dividing the number by all possible primes and check whether the result is an integer, but that takes very long time on a conventional computer. The current RSA encryption uses primes of 2048 bits, that's somewhat more than 600 digits in the decimal system. Factoring a number that large on a conventional computer takes trillions of years. A large enough quantum computer, however, could do it within seconds. And that has a lot of people getting very nervous. It's not because the internet will become unsafe. We know encryption protocols that are safe from quantum computers, and efforts are currently underway to switch to those quantum-safe encryption protocols. However, that doesn't solve the problem that in the past, a lot of secret data has been encrypted with RSA and similar protocols. If these can be broken, everyone in possession of this data will suddenly be able to decipher it. This is why you can bet any intelligence agency on the planet is currently hoarding encrypted data from everyone else and trying to get their hands on the first quantum computer to have an early start when everyone begins leaking once secret data. It's a real threat, and if it happens, it'll be a political nightmare. That's why Q-Day is a headache. Not because the internet will become unsafe, but because old data can be deciphered. But just how big does a quantum computer have to be to decode RSA? Estimates from computer scientists say it'll take something like 10 million physical qubits. Physical qubits are the real thing that you have in your quantum computer. They should not be confused with logical qubits, which are hypothetical error-free qubits that are often being used in the computer science literature. The current record for physical qubits is held by IBM and is at roughly 1,000. Though, as I discussed in an earlier episode, we don't know the quality of those qubits, so it doesn't really mean much. In any case, we're far, far away from the number of qubits needed to break RSA. And there are other applications that you could do on a quantum computer before that, because they require fewer qubits, such as solving some problems in quantum chemistry. But Q-Day threats heated up a little over a year ago when a Chinese team claimed in a preprint to have dramatically reduced the number of qubits that had been needed to break RSA. They said that if they combine the quantum calculation with a conventional supercomputer, they can break the 2048-bit RSA encryption with merely 372 physical qubits. If that was correct, that'd indeed be a very big deal, because that'd plausibly become possible within the next 5 years or so. The claim was met with much skepticism. Another group set up to test the result but was unable to reproduce it. So let me just say, I was a little surprised that, according to Business Insider, experts say that Q-Day could arrive as soon as 2025. There's no way, and who are experts anyway. It turns out that experts is Thilo Kunz of Quantum Defense. I hope I'm reading this right. Or should it be Defen5? Defen5? Well, whatever the pronunciation, it's a startup which is selling protection against the cyber threats of the future, and it's probably not much of a business to sell protection against threats that, by our reasonable estimates, are at least 30 years in the future. But I promised quokkas. What does any of this have to do with quokkas? I recently learned on Twitter that there's an Australian company by the name Quokka Quantum that's selling a device called the Quokka Puck, and that they market as your personal quantum computer. It's not an actual quantum computer, it's a conventional computer that simulates a quantum computer. This is known as a quantum emulation. Yes, you can calculate what a quantum computer does on a normal computer, because we can just integrate the equations of quantum mechanics. The problem is, of course, that as the number of qubits increases, this quantum emulation is going to become very slow. Back to the Quokka Pucks. That they were being marketed as quantum computers rather than emulators caused a shitstorm in a tea glass, so to speak, by which I mean few people took notice. I still find it interesting because it highlights a trend we've seen for several years now. There's been so much hype around quantum computing as the technology of the future that companies are popping up left and right to prepare us for the supposed future, like the Quantum Defen5 or the Quokka Puck. It's not necessarily a bad thing. I mean, personally, I think there are better ways to waste your money. Check out my Patreon. But then again, that's just me. No, I just find it fascinating how many ways there are to make money from other people's lack of scientific literacy. Maybe I should be selling quantum candy. They say that no one understands quantum mechanics. I think it's not true. It's totally understandable. If you want to give it a try yourself, check out my quantum mechanics course on brilliant.org. You can take this course without bringing background knowledge. It'll help you to understand what a wave function is and what the difference is between superpositions and entanglement. It also covers interference, the uncertainty principle, and Bell's theorem. And after that, you can continue maybe with their course on quantum computing or neural nets. Brilliant covers a large number of topics in science, computer science, and mathematics, and they're adding new courses each month. And of course, I have a special offer for viewers of this channel. If you use my link brilliant.org/Sabine, you'll get to try everything Brilliant has to offer for free for a full 30 days, and you'll get 20% off an annual premium subscription. Links in the description below, so go and check this out. Thanks for watching. See you tomorrow.